Hi viewers, welcome to our channel. In this video, we'll discuss about what is plaster, how cracks are formed in the plaster, different types of cracks, how to avoid these cracks in plaster, and finally, the procedure to repair these shrinkage cracks. So without wasting our time, let me introduce myself. My name is Vinay, and if you are visiting my channel for the first time, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also, click the bell icon. Let's start our video. What is plaster? Plaster is a building material used for the protective or decorative coating of walls and ceilings and for molding and casting decorative elements. But do you know how they are used? First, the most common types of plaster mainly contain either gypsum, lime or cement, but all work in a similar way. The plaster is manufactured as a dry powder and mixed with water to form a stiff but workable paste immediately before it is applied to the surface. The reaction of dry material with water liberates heat through crystallization, and the hydrated plaster then hardens with time. So how cracks are formed in plaster? We need to understand cracks first. Crack is a line on the surface of something along which it has split without breaking apart. Cracks in plaster walls are generally caused as a result of settlement of ground, vibration or atmospheric conditions, but some may due to faulty construction practices. Different types of cracks. Early cracks in the plasters aren't just unpleasant, but they are indicative to something wrong in material selection or the procedure used for application. The most common defects observed in plasters are plastic shrinkage cracks and drying shrinkage cracks. Let us now understand the reasons of occurrence of these cracks in plasters and steps to be taken to minimize them. First, plastic shrinkage. Plastic shrinkage crack results when an excessive water is lost from the plaster in the first few hours of its application. When the cracks are noticed while the plaster is still plastic, they are often floated and closed at the site. But it's not a good practice, as these cracks reappear after some time near the future. So how to avoid these plastic shrinkage cracks? Protect the plaster from sun and wind to avoid drying too quickly. Initiate plastering timing to avoid direct sunlight and strong wind on plastering surfaces. Saturate the masonry wall adequately with water before plastering, because this will avoid brickwork from absorbing the water in the plaster. Start curing as early as possible if the weather is hot, windy and dry. Do not use sand which lacks fine material. Use sand of fineness modulus between 2.4 to 2.6. If sand lacks fine material, then add some lime into the cement plaster. So these are practices which have to be implemented to avoid plastic shrinkage cracks. So now we will discuss about drying shrinkage. Drying shrinkage results due to moisture loss after plaster has hardened. Plaster is bound to shrink and crack. Usually, plaster applied in layers that are too thick, that is greater than 20 mm, will tend to crack in this way. These cracks are normally stable and can be filled with crack repair mortar and painted over. It is possible to reduce drying shrinkage and hence the resultant cracks. So now how to avoid these drying shrinkage cracks? Do not use very fine sand. It requires more water. That means don't use sand with fineness modulus less than 2.2. We recommend usage of plaster sand for plastering purposes. Do not use rich plaster mix because it contains high cement content. Use cement mortar mix of 1:4 ratio or below depending upon the quality of sand. Avoid OPC, instead use fly ash blended cement, that is Portland Pozzolana cement. PPC has less heat of hydration, so will result in lesser cracks as compared to OPC. Use water reducing admixtures in plaster mix. Also, avoid very thick plaster layers, that is greater than 15 mm. But if you need more thickness, build these plasters in layers of 12 to 15 mm with a gap of at least 3 days. Do the curing immediately after the setting time of plaster mortar for a period of minimum 7 days. Now we discussed what are the different types of cracks and how to avoid these cracks. So now let us discuss the procedure to repair these shrinkage cracks. Shrinkage cracks are small, up to 2 mm. These take random directions, appearing in plaster walls and ceilings. Usually these are nothing to worry about the main structure, because it will still sound. These are basically classified as non-structural cracks. If paints are applied on it without attending the original cracks, the cracks shall be visible on the painted surface. A eyesore for all. So, shrinkage cracks in plasters should be first be widened, so that filler can be pushed right in and has something to key onto. The corner of a scraper or filling put in knife is ideal for removing the loose plaster. Dry paint brush can be used along the line of the crack to remove any loose dust and dirt. Mix a quantity of filler as per the manufacturer's instructions. And before applying it, dampen the inside of the crack using a small paint brush dipped in a clean water, but don't soak the crack. Now apply the crack filler paste, a polymer modified ready to use paste, example Dr. Fix It, into the crack in plaster. Then use a filling or putty knife to apply the filler along the line of the crack and press the filler into it. Dip a clean filling or putty knife in clean water and run it along the line of the crack to level the filler to the surface around it. The treated surface can now be taken up for painting. So this is the main procedure followed for shrinkage cracks. If you have any doubt regarding this video, you can comment below. I will answer you within 24 hours. If you find anything useful in this video, please share with your friends. And if you like our video, please give a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also, click the bell icon. See you in the next video. Thank you.